¡Buen día al Medio Oeste! Este es el programa de televisión que te da noticias, información, entretenimiento y mucho más. Ahora, quédate con nuestros anfitriones al día.
Muy buenas noches a todos, aquí con ustedes nuevamente en el programa Al Día. Y bueno, en esta tarde vamos a estar en Costa Rica, en Centroamérica, donde hay playas maravillosas, así que no se lo pierdan.
Claro que sí, amigos, y en este show también tenemos una entrevista muy interesante con nuestra amiga Julie, que trabaja para Face It Together.
¿Y qué les cuento? Tenemos a nuestro productor Alex cocinando una delicia que vamos a tener que verla con los ojos cerrados.
Nos gusta
verla.
Una delicia con los ojos cerrados.
Con los ojos cerrados para nada más ver la entrevista así.
Con los ojos cerrados y la boca abierta.
Exacto. Y ya después de la entrevista, entonces ya podemos ver. Porque con esta hambrita que hace, imagínate.
No, y que él es excelente cocinero.
Ya sé, nos van a antojar.
Pues es lo que dicen. Yo ya no aguanto las ganas de comer esta comida. Bueno, ¿saben qué? ¿Por qué no nos vamos a la entrevista con Julie en Face It Together? Regresamos, claro, amigos, no le cambien.
Al día.
You know, at Face It Together Sioux Falls, we help both individuals who are suffering from the disease of addiction and also family members who are affected by another's disease. We offer recovery support services, so that might be something like someone walking into the center, maybe either for themselves or for a family member looking for, how do I go to treatment maybe? You know, there's that, if you've never navigated that type of system before, it can be really confusing, so it's nice to have someone here, whether it's a staff member or volunteer, who can help guide that process. You know, we're actually quite different. We work with treatment providers, but we don't actually offer like an intensive outpatient program or any kind of residential program. What we do is totally different. We are the hub, really. We're like a clearinghouse. So we have connections with all different resources within the community to help people, like I was talking about, maybe first, if they're needing that referral, to go get an assessment done or to go get started on a treatment program. We can visit with someone and say, okay, you know, do you have insurance or what are your main issues, and kind of point them in, these might be your best three options. You know, let's start from there. Let's help you make some phone calls. And then we don't endorse any specific pathway. There's some treatment facilities that are very 12-step based or very faith-based or, you know, something like that. There's kind of a guided direction that people are being placed in. We think that there's many pathways to recovery, so we want to help every individual find their own path. You know, I like to run. That's my thing. I've been in recovery for over 9 years. You know, and some of my best friends go to AA meetings regularly. One of our staff members here, he's a leader in the SMART recovery group. There's so many people who find recovery through spiritual-based organizations too. So it's just kind of, we work to help each individual find what's the right path for them. You know, anyone can access our services. Everything that we do free of charge. We have United Way funding and also funding from different employers in the community as well as private donors. So we don't charge for any of our services. So it's just a matter of getting connected with us. Whether you pick up the phone and call, you can call any time of day. Somebody's going to answer the phone, whether it's during office hours or we have an answering service that also takes care of our calls. Say in the middle of the night, you're thinking, I really need to talk to somebody. I want to start talking. Pick up the phone and call. You can call 605-274-2262, or you can always check out our website. It's www.faceitsiouxfalls.org, and there's an info email there, info@faceitsiouxfalls.org. Somebody will get back to you within 24 hours if you drop a line there. For some people, that sort of not having to actually talk to somebody in the first step is a little bit easier. So we like having that email option as well. You know, otherwise just stop into the center. Monday through Thursday, we're open from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. And then 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. on Friday. Also Saturday mornings from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. You know, I think number one health issue in the community and in our country, you know, billions and billions of dollars is the cost of addiction, really, if you get down to the bottom line of it. And also, you know, even more severe than that, the lives lost and the lives affected. In Sioux Falls, you could say that there's probably 18 to 20,000 people over the age of 12 who suffer from the disease of addiction. You know, some people in recovery, some people not. And the issue there is that a lot of people don't get the help that they need. You know, every year about 90% of people don't reach out for help. And the unfortunate thing is that there are so many programs and so many resources out there, but there's so much stigma and shame and fear that's associated with addiction. That's a big thing too that we work on is the awareness piece of it, because here at Face It Together Sioux Falls, we know addiction is a disease, but we know it's a treatable chronic disease like diabetes or like hypertension. You know, you just have to take better care of yourself and learn how to manage that disease. For the longest time, addiction was looked at as a moral failing. You know, it was looked at like, well, you just can't control yourself. Well, you know, it's a brain disease. And when we bring the dialogue up and we're having conversations like this and we're raising awareness and making people understand that this is a disease and this is something you should talk to your doctor about, you know, and that you're not a bad person if you think you have a problem, but you know, go talk to your doctor, have that first visit. I think as long as we keep this dialogue going, more people are going to keep getting well and some of that stigma is going to keep going away. The unfortunate thing I think too with addiction is that it does cost so much because we've treated it in an episodic fashion. You know, we wait until someone's going to the emergency room, or we wait until someone's been arrested, and then all of a sudden it's like, whoa, this is this big problem. You know, with other diseases, we don't do that. You know, we have the conversation with our doctor when symptoms first start. And when we can get to that point with addiction where we're working on where we treat this as a chronic disease and not as an episodic disease, then, you know, we're making progress there. And I think then we're going to see the costs go down, we're going to save lives, and get more people well, you know, and get people to realize that life is amazing and wonderful. And being in recovery, you know, I don't put a label on myself like, well, I'm an alcoholic. I just don't do that. It's like, you know what, I'm well, I'm happy, and I'm in recovery, and life is great now because of that. So I just want to keep talking about that and spreading that message to people and letting people know that life can be a lot better, you know. You know, we want to make sure that everybody knows that this is not a place of judgment. We accept you exactly where we're at, where you're at. We understand that recurrence of symptoms or relapse is part of the disease. You know, someone might be sober for several years or several decades, you know, and then something happens and the disease gets triggered back up. There's other diseases that we've really started to rally around people. You know, there's different cancer awareness events like breast cancer walks and stuff. You know, people really embrace their friends and their family members that have suffered, and they shower them with love and they say it's okay and we're gonna get through this. We haven't quite gotten to that point yet with addiction, you know, and I think we will. I really do. I think we can. And that's why I work here, and that's why I believe so strongly in what I do, because we need to get on par with the recognition of the other diseases, you know, that banding together and rallying around people and supporting each other. It's a disease, and it's something that's treatable and manageable, and lots of us who are in recovery have learned to live really meaningful, productive lives. So we always, too, try to send the message here that there's always hope, and we want people to understand that a life of recovery is a great life, you know, and that there's a caring recovery community here, and we want you to come join us.
Bueno, amigos, regresamos después de esta pausa comercial.
When it comes to healthcare, 9-to-5 isn't always an option for me. I get my annual screenings, but I'm not stopping for sinus infections or allergies, even though I probably should. That's why Avera Now is perfect for me. I could grab my phone, computer, or tablet, and the health system I trust is there for me instantly, and I go back to not missing a beat.
Moving at the speed of life. Avera Now.
Productos de concreto Gage Brothers está contratando. Te necesitamos. ¿Y qué necesitas para ser parte de nuestro equipo?
Una buena actitud.
Habilidad para aprender.
Trabajar en equipo.
Atención con los detalles.
Ganas de trabajar.
Orgullo en tu trabajo.
Si esto suena como tú, entonces esta es tu oportunidad.
Únete a nosotros.
Aplica hoy en nuestras oficinas.
En la 4301 Oeste 12 Street.
Oyendo en línea a GageBrothers.com.
Únete a nuestro equipo hoy mismo. Gage Brothers.
Se trata de divertirse mientras aprendes.
se trata de desarrollar hábitos para toda la vida. Se trata de crecer carácter, pero también de crecer. Pero crecer no quiere decir crecer aparte. La experiencia de los Scouts crea mejores uniones en la familia, mientras los padres e hijos aprenden y se divierten juntos. Sé parte de algo especial para ti y tu hijo. Envuélvete en los Scouts hoy mismo.
Bueno, amigos, ya estamos de regreso. Muchachas, ¿qué les pareció la entrevista de Face It Together?
Interesante, pues muy bueno ese lugar para que la gente la guíen y sepa claro. Dónde tiene que ir exactamente.
Claro, sí, hay muchas personas que desgraciadamente tienen problemas de adicciones y todo eso. Uh-huh. Esta compañía se encarga de mandarlos a donde ellos necesiten.
De guiarlos.
Como ustedes vieron en el reportaje, y claro, ahí hay mucha información. Y también tienen la página en el internet donde pueden conectarse para tener números de teléfono y todo eso.
Uh-huh. Está muy bien. Amigos, pues ahora vamos con nuestro chef profesional Alex, que nos tiene unas deliciosas, creo que son enchiladas con camarón. Vamos a verlo.
Y aquí detrás de cámara nos los comemos, ¿verdad?
Imagínate que tuvieran un plato.
Hey, man.
Hey! Hola, my name is Alex Ramirez, and today I'm gonna teach you how to grill a Mexican meal. First thing we need is three things. Your hat, just in case it's hot. You need your umbrella, just in case it starts raining. And you need your chihuahua, just in case you wanna keep your floor clean. There you go. Today, we're gonna make shrimp enchiladas. In addition, we're gonna have scallops with corn. The first thing you wanna do is you wanna get a little tray like this, and you want to put a little bit of olive oil. Be generous. Then you take the mole. This is the mole, couple of dollars, any Mexican store. And you put a little bit of mole in there like this. Actually, you might need a little spoon to pull it out. We'll use a knife like this. That should be enough. Then you put a little bit of Mexican chocolate. Another great buy for only $2 at the Mexican store. You put it in, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it inside the grill, and we're gonna let it melt a little bit, just like that. Preheat your grill to 300. Right now it's somewhere around 500, but we're just gonna ignore that for now. Now we're gonna take some of these elotes, corn, and we're gonna take a couple of the leaves off, because we're actually gonna use this on the scallops in just a few moments. We're gonna throw the corn in here, just so then they can start cooking nicely. You don't need to wash them, you don't need to do anything to them. They're all protected in there. Make sure you break up the chocolate. Now we're gonna work on the shrimp. All we're gonna do is we're just gonna fix them here nicely. Now you sprinkle a little salt, you put a little garlic powder, put a little paprika. If you feel really macho, you can use a little bit of chile de árbol. It's the really spicy stuff. This will be done in less than 5 minutes. Always check them. When they're pink, you know they're ready. This is a dinner for two, so we're gonna do 6 tortillas. First, we warm them up. We let them sit for a little bit, then we turn them. Shrimps are almost ready. Right now, we're gonna take out the tortillas. And what we're gonna do with this is we're gonna stick them on the chile, just like this. Let them get all nice and full, then put them on the side. Now we're gonna take out our shrimp, and we're gonna chop it up. We're gonna put a little bit of shrimp, just like that. We're gonna turn it like this. Now we're gonna add a little bit of mozzarella cheese on top. Just like that. Sabroso! Now we're gonna put it back in there for another minute, maybe two. Now we're gonna add our platanos. That's gonna be our dessert. Now we're gonna do our scallops. We're gonna put them in these leaves. This is the elote leaves, just like this. And we're gonna put a little bit of garlic here. Of course, we're gonna add a little more salt, a little tomato. Like that in the middle. Good thing we have this nice tree full of limes over here. This one's good. Just a couple of slices like this. Now we're ready to put it on the fire like that. Woo. We're gonna start by taking out the enchiladas. Now we're gonna fix our first plate. We're gonna put the enchiladas like that. We're gonna put a little bit of this on top, just like this. I'll put a little bit of sliced onion, Mexican cheese on top. Just like this, put a little tomato, a set of our scallops, our corn, And look at that corn, it's nice and ready. Now we're gonna shave a little bit of this onto our scallops, and we do a little bit of juice on this with a little bit of salt. You can even put a little bit on this too. Fancy it up a little like this. Now we're ready to eat. Now we're gonna grab our banana. We're gonna put a little bit of condensed milk. Just a little bit. Well, I guess it depends on taste. You can put a little bit less, a little bit more. A little bit of cinnamon, just like that. Oh, that is gonna be so good.
Grilling is so simple. You can practically do it anywhere. So let's enjoy.
Bueno amigos, quédense con nosotros, regresamos después de estos comerciales.
When it comes to healthcare, 9-to-5 isn't always an option for me. I get my annual screenings, but I'm not stopping for sinus infections or allergies, even though I probably should. That's why Avera Now is perfect for me. I could grab my phone, computer, or tablet, and the health system I trust is there for me instantly. And I go back to not missing a beat.
Moving at the speed of life. Avera Now.
Productos de concreto Gage Brothers está contratando. Te necesitamos y ¿qué necesitas para ser parte de nuestro equipo?
Una buena actitud.
Habilidad para aprender.
Trabajar en equipo.
Atención con los detalles.
Ganas de trabajar.
Orgullo en tu trabajo.
Si esto suena como tú, entonces esta es tu oportunidad.
Únete a nosotros.
Aplica hoy en nuestras oficinas.
En la 4301 Oeste 12 Street.
Oyendo en línea a GageBrother.com.
Únete a nuestro equipo hoy mismo. Gage Brothers.
Bueno amigos, ya estamos de regreso y adivinen qué tenemos ahorita.
¿Qué?
Saludos.
Ah, los saludos. Vámonos a la sección de los saludos, muchachas.
Saludables que somos.
No,
de saludos desde hola. Les voy a decir hola de parte de Reinaldo Castillo a Luis Medina, que está aquí radicando en la ciudad de Sioux Falls desde Sinaloa. Saludos a todos los sinaloenses.
Luis Medina, saludos.
Saludos. ¿Quién más? ¿Quién más tiene saluditos?
Jackie, a ver, ¿quién?
Bueno, yo voy a saludar a mis hermanos en New York. Alex y César.
Alex y César en New York.
Y a mi hermano Mike también, a los tres que están en New York. Un saludo.
Bueno, pues yo nada más a todos mis amigos de aquí de Sioux Falls, que nada más son muchos, yo creo que nada más uno. No es cierto. No quiero mencionar nombres en general, a todos mis amigos de aquí de Sioux Falls y a toda mi familia en México, Monterrey y todos esos lugares. Nadie en especial, porque después se me enojan.
Sí, un saludo para todos en general, a los televidentes. Que y nuestra ahí con nosotros.
A nuestro productor también, a Alex, a su mami, a toda su familia también allá, a sus chiquillos, ¿verdad? Que nosotros
y a nuestro fotógrafo.
Nuestro fotógrafo también.
Fotógrafo de planta. un fotógrafo
profesional.
Sí,
saludos.
Profesional. Bueno, chicos.
Bueno, ahora vámonos para Costa Rica. Así que no se lo pierdan.
Al día.
We'll be right back.
healthcare, 9-to-5 isn't always an option for me. I get my annual screenings, but I'm not stopping for sinus infections or allergies, even though I probably should.
That's why Avera Now is perfect for me. I could grab my phone, computer, or tablet, and the health system I trust is there for me instantly. And I go back to not missing a beat.
Moving at the speed of life. Avera Now.
Productos de concreto Gage Brothers está contratando. Te necesitamos y ¿qué necesitas para ser parte de nuestro equipo?
Una buena actitud.
Habilidad para aprender.
Trabajar en equipo.
Atención con los detalles.
Ganas de trabajar.
Orgullo en tu trabajo.
Si esto suena como tú,
entonces esta es tu oportunidad.
Únete a nosotros.
Aplica hoy en nuestras oficinas.
En la 4301 Oeste 12 Street.
Oyendo en línea a GageBrother.com.
Únete a nuestro equipo hoy mismo. Gage Brothers.
Bueno, amigos, ¿qué tal les pareció Costa Rica?
Ah, estaba muy interesante. Yo quiero irme de vacaciones para allá.
Qué bonito. Las playas espectaculares.
¿Sabes qué? A ver, ¿cuándo le decimos a la producción que nos mande a Costa Rica por una semanita? Yo creo que estaría muy bien, ¿no?
Pues sí. Por ahora yo me conformo que me enviaron a Francia.
Ay, mira. Oye, qué bueno. Así que nos mandas muchos videos de allá.
Sí, claro. Fotos también.
Bueno, pues yo creo que se nos acabó el programa otra vez.
Así es.
Oye, sí. Nada más esta media hora se pasa volando cuando la pasamos aquí de diversión. Tanto de diversión.
Sí, y información nosotros también para todos ustedes.
Claro, claro que sí. ¿Saben qué, amigos? Les queremos recordar que empezando en febrero 11, nuestro nuevo horario que va a ser todos los sábados de 8:30 a 9 de la mañana. Así es. Que para esos que se quedaban dormidos y no nos podían ver.
Ya no más excusas, ya nos pueden ver en la mañana.
Ya no va a haber excusas. Ahora se tienen que ir a la casa, a la cama tempranito, como no se querían desvelar.
Madrugar a vernos.
Para madrugar a vernos. También acuérdense que empieza nuestro programa después de El Sol.
El Sol TV.
Así que nuestros amigos...
Van a tener dos programas en español.
En español.
¡Saludos!
Va a haber una hora de programación en español en Fox TV.
Así es.
¡Qué bueno! Así vamos como latinos.
Claro que sí.
Muy bien.
Claro que sí. Más adelante, pues ojalá que a lo mejor sería otra hora de hispana y nos vamos a agarrar todo el sábado en español. ¿Qué les parece?
Estaría perfecto. Estaría muy bien.
¿Y en qué?
Con telenovela y todo.
Oye, con telenovela, que ahora somos actores y actrices de telenovela. No, aquí, mira, aquí, y aquí llegó otra actriz de telenovela, claro que sí. Amigos, muchas gracias por estar con nosotros y no se les olvide, como siempre, sintonizarse en KTTW, en el canal Fox para ver nuestro programa y también en la página.
En la página de Facebook nos pueden ver también al diatv.com.
Claro, ¿y en dónde más?
En YouTube también.
Sí. Claro que sí.
Así que no hay excusa para vernos.
Si se perdieron alguno de nuestros episodios, lo puede repetir o buscar en nuestras páginas Al Día TV.
Así que esperamos que haya sido su agrado y han disfrutado de este programa.
Bueno, amigos, nos vemos la próxima semana y quédense con nosotros
Al Día. Día.
Oye, que bien se portó el chat, ya viste que no va a sonar.
Muchas gracias a nuestros patrocinadores.